Hey guys, Matt here from MK-SmartHouse.com, and in this video, I'm going to show you around the OpenHAB 2 web user interfaces. OpenHAB is a great platform, and there are many things you can do on it. But something new that happened is in OpenHAB 2, they introduced the OpenHAB web UI, where you can see all the different user interfaces. To access the web UI, open up your web browser and head over to your Pi's IP address, with colon 8080 on the end. Mine is 192.168.0.4:8080. It should look like a bunch of rectangles and say, welcome to OpenHAB 2. First up is the basic UI. This is the user interface that we'll create later on in the next video when we talk about the OpenHAB configuration files. Next up is paper UI, and this is the administrative web user interface. The first tab on the left side is control. And here we would be able to control the devices that we have connected. Then we have inbox. This is where the system would search for devices when you have bindings installed. I will show you more of this in the future when we add devices. After that is configuration, which has subtabs, starting with system, where you can change a few things in OpenHAB. I usually do not touch anything here. In the bindings subtab, it would show you all the bindings you have installed that are version 2. Currently, I don't have any that are version 2 because it is a fresh install that we did in the last set of videos. And we installed MQTT, which is version 1.9, so it does not show up here. The services subtab is like bindings, except instead of showing you all your bindings, it shows services. We will configure basic UI and classic UI in the next video, and the HAB panel will be configured much later on. If you look up top, there is a voice tab, but I don't use that. Next subtab is things. And in here, it would show you all the devices or things you have connected. For example, later on, we might have a Belkin Wemo light switch or a Samsung Smart TV. The final subtab is the item subtab, where you connect the things to items to provide individual data. For example, a thing could be a light switch, and two items for the light switch could be its state, as well as turn it on or off. The next tab is the add-ons tab, and in here we have many add-ons or pieces of software so we can connect devices. In the last video, when we were setting up the server, we installed the MQTT binding, but there are so many more. Have a look for yourself. But there are not just bindings, there are also different user interfaces you can install, persistence, actions, transformations, voice, and other miscellaneous things. The final tab on the right is the preferences tab, and here you just select your language. The next user interface is the REST API, and this is where you can do HTTP stuff. Personally, I don't use it. Then we have classic UI, which is the same thing as basic UI, it just looks different. HABMIN is next, and it just has so many features that I can't cover them all, but essentially it is another administrative thing that I don't use enough. Finally is HABPANEL, which is new with OpenHAB 2, and I just love it so much. If you watched my Smart House demo video, this is what the wall-mounted interface was running. I will show you more of this when we make a wall-mounted interface. That is it for the OpenHAB 2 web interface. There isn't really too much to it, and that's what makes it so awesome. The point of this video was just to do a walk around of the OpenHAB web interface, so you know where everything is as well as which videos will cover those parts. Which means that I will show you how to use the parts when the time comes. In the next video, we will be talking about the OpenHAB configuration files, as well as setting up the user interface for the smart home. Alright, thank you for watching, and if you have any questions, leave them in the comment section below, or head over to the mksmarthouse.com/forum, where you have a better chance of it getting answered. Goodbye!